T-5586. Out of Kansas City, Missouri, Sting R.
Over on the blue line, set, we welcome back Team 48.
Out of Warren, Ohio, that's Delphi Elite.
This team also in the top eight. What time is it?
5:30. Out of Buckwanago, it's the Bears.
And rounding out the blue line, the cheese curd herd is back 171.
They're out of Platteville.
Pilots, ready for flight. Drivers behind the line. 3, 2, 1, go.
All right, here we go. Man's number 69 underway. Everybody moving in autonomous. Delphi Elite and Buckwanago both shooting for the Blue Alliance. Delphi Elite able to put a couple into the high goal. Buckwanago's went off to the side. But the Blue Alliance with those 5 KPAs for hitting those fuel cells in have a 5-point lead. We go down under 2 minutes to go in the match. We're going to see how that plays out as the match progresses. Those fuel cell balls. Buckwanago putting a few more in. The Bears, 9:30 for Blue. Counting down to about a minute and a half to go in the match. Both alliances with two rotors spinning. So both working on their third rotor. You need 4 gears to get that third rotor spinning. Red's got two of them in place. Blue with two as well. Now a third one. So Blue just needs one more, Red needs one more as well. Next gear we'll get their third rotor going for both alliances. The Bears shooting some more of those fuel cells up. There's the third gear now spinning for the Red Alliance. We go down under a minute, about 3/4 of a minute remaining. Fourth gear in place now for Blue as well. So both alliances with three rotors spinning, still have an advantage for the Blue Alliance, and that looks to be those KPAs for getting those fuel cells into the boiler. That's making a difference, giving Blue an advantage. We hear the audio indicator going under 30 seconds. It's now the end game, and the robots can fly into the airship. One move of the red robot up in the air, second robot trying to fly. 10 seconds remaining. Two red robots up, third one trying, two blue ones up. And a